Hello, and welcome to another week ahead reading. So there's pile one, pile two, pile three. Take a deep breath. And out. Pause this video if you have to, and see what pile you're drawn to. Okay, let's get into this.
Okay, your beginning of the week, we've got Four of Summer. Being distracted and failing to see a magical opportunity, taking someone or something for granted, discontent with life. So if you've been feeling a little bit distracted lately, kind of not in this world currently, the middle of the week, you have got Ego. This is a major arcana card. The illusion of being trapped, placing too much importance on material items, getting caught up in fear and worry. So have you been fearing something? Have you been worrying? You also got Ace of Summer. Open your heart to love, the beginning of a new intimate relationship or the rebirth of a current one. The awakening of psychic abilities or spiritual empathies. So things, new beginnings on something. That could even be friendships. It could be your relationship's just going to be improving, or a new beginnings in your spiritual abilities that you can do. At the end of the week, we've got the Sun. Plans that work out perfectly, amazing ideas that lead to rewards and commendations. Gratitude for the blessings of life. So there's definitely new beginnings that I'm seeing here. You know, at the beginning, you are feeling a little bit distracted. You are feeling like you're not really here, you're not present in life. And then just as we're going into the middle of the week, you're kind of just, you're starting to wake up. And you're getting this new beginning. Amazing. So out of the oracle cards, you got spring. The arrival of spring represents a spirit of hope and fresh beginnings. Again, beginnings. It's heralded in nature by bursts of fresh, vibrant colour, adored in gardens, parks and woods, and some of nature's sweetest perfumes in the air. After long dark days of winter, the first green shoots of life reappear, a sign that life goes on. It's a time of birth and growth, of natural energy and hope and optimism for the future. You kind of got about birth in one of these. I think it was this one. Yes, you did. That fits perfectly. Your next oracle card is Pluto. Pluto is named after the Roman god of the underworld. Despite being reclassified as a dwarf planet, its influence is strong. Pluto represents death and destruction, like its namesake, however, is also linked to rebirth. There's a lot of rebirth here. Regeneration, transformation, and renewal. Pluto is associated with secrets and deeply buried things, both literal and metaphorical, intensity, passion, and power. So you are transforming yourself, and there's death, so something's ending, and then you've got birth, and something new is coming. So one door's closing and one door's opening. And then you've got the East. The East is a place of the enlightenment or awakening. We've got about awakening of psychic abilities and spiritual infinities. Symbolizes that is understood in both Christian churches and Buddhist temples, where the altar is positioned in the East. The East is the triumph of rebirth over death, and it is a direction of the infant, new beginnings, fresh ideas, and inspiration. Wow, so you're going to be inspired next week. Alright, let's see. Advice from the angels. You got vulnerability, so you're going to be vulnerable this next week. Only the brave and open-hearted dare to allow themselves to be vulnerable, for it requires courage to take down all walls and expose your humanness. Your agent guidance is to become aware of your defense mechanisms, which keep you separate from others. With the divine, ask your angels to help you dissolve your mask and barriers so that your fragile, true self can emerge. Like a butterfly in its cocoon, the world is freedom, love, and a sense of inner safety. So dare to be vulnerable and open. You also got positivity, so you got to be positive this next week. When you are positive, you keep directing a stream of high vibration energy with your thoughts, words, and actions. This affects others and they help you towards your purpose. The angels are aware of the power of your positivity and they too will support your intentions. You choose your thoughts and attitudes, so focus on loving abundant and successful outcomes in every area of life. Your positivity will make you feel happy, healthy and fulfilled. You also got some messages from the spirits here. You got, I live for little moments, and when you see a red flag, don't let it bloody you. Bright one. Your self-care for this week is movement. I say this week, next week. I feel embodied, empowered to move with strength and grace. Create a clear energy flow throughout your body by introducing a new movement practice into your life. Structured or free flowing, this could be anything from yoga, walking or qigong to rock climbing, running or swimming, whatever suits your taste. With any movement practice, the most important thing is to tune into how your body is feeling and move into a supportive way. Relish the feeling of being present inside your malicious body. Diversity your movement practices so that you're working in all areas of your body. Seek out a new or forgotten movement practice to help you gently push the boundaries of your comfort zone. It's better to start small than not start at all. Even if it's just 50 minutes per day, get your body moving in a way that feels exhilarating for you. A journal prompt: what movement practice would you like to try but find excuses not to pursue? How would working through these blocks and moving more freely make you feel? Let's do some dice. Okay, can you answer the situation with these tarot cards? Right. Okay, so we have Sun energy, we have Gemini energy, and we have number house 3. The planet die represents the situation at hand. This has made me laugh because the situation at hand is ego. And you have ego there. Basic self. Consciousness, so you need to come out of this distracting self and come to your consciousness. Virtuality, stamina, and creation. And we've got about birth here. New beginnings. The zodiac die represents how the situation's making you feel and the emotions involved with the situation. You got duality. Mischievous, emotions are over rationality, cleverness, and curiosity. Okay, the house die represents what part of your life is being affected. And you've got siblings, people tied to you by blood and location, short journeys, small vacations and travel, school, early education for children. Expect emails, letters, advice, but watch out for gossip and rumours. Let's do your letters. Okay, we have A, S, K, O, Q, P, Y, W, O, K, R, M, and C. Okay, let's get you some numbers. We have got 8, 8, so that could be an angel number, 1 and 7. Let's get you some charms. Okay, let's have a look. We got 2 zeros. We got another 2. Oh, no, you didn't have a 2 before. 2. 11. So, 3 11, so that could be an angel number. You have a 10 in your focus bowl. Okay, you have the heart is open, so maybe someone's going to open their heart to you, or you need to open your heart. We have the seahorse, so maybe you're going to be diving into something, into some creativity, some sort of an adventure. You have Frank Randall here, so this is about someone that's got flaws, but that's okay. You have a shining knight, so maybe someone's going to come into your life, be friendship, relationship, or someone that's already in your life that you feel like they're your knight in shining armor. Make of it as you will. Finances are probably going to be improved because there's this penny here. You have a guardian angel watching over you. The underground, so that was about traveling. So yeah, that represents traveling. The blue stone here, that's about healing. If I remember rightly, it's about water as well. So maybe nice to have a nice bubbly bath. It's about the throat chakra. Yeah, and reducing your blood pressure. You have the spider here, so that's about planning, creativity. It's also about feminine energy. It's about learning to heal. You also have the number 16. And inside here in your focus bowl, you also have courage and sea world. Thank you, pile one, for watching. Hello, pile two. So your beginning of the week is five of winter. Walk away from dishonest associations, realizing that what you thought you wanted isn't the best choice for your happiness, something that's not worth the effort. So you're going to be walking away from something at the beginning of next week. Something's not going to work out for you, and you're going to realize that, and you're going to walk away, and you're going to realize they weren't your time, or the opportunity wasn't your time. Something, you're just going to be walking away from something. Now, at the middle of the week, you have Prince of Spring here. This could also represent someone in your life, could be you. They're charming, self-confident, passionate, restless. Immediate action, a challenge you can successfully manage, and a passionate relationship. So this is a passionate relationship, really passionate I'm getting from this. And also you've got unity. Do the right thing for the right reason. Compare traditional versus new approaches to see which works for you. A spiritual-minded community. So at the beginning of the week, it's telling you to break out the box and consider new and creative modes of accomplishing your goals. It also says discussing various methods, old and new, with those you trust can help you which philosophy to follow at any given time. If your goals are meeting with resistance, it may be due to the method you are using to attain them, rather than the flaw in your actual plans. Be open to trusted people's perceptions regarding the right strategy to take. Having a support group of friends and a spiritual teacher who walks his or her talk will uplift you and allow you to stand tall into your work. It's important to always stay on a path of integrity in every aspect of life. The law of attraction awards those who follow their dreams while remain honest and true in dealing with others. Align yourself with organisations of people who have high spiritual ideals. In this card, our two fairy students have found a mentor to teach them both old and new ways of thinking. It's about doing the right thing for the right reason, remaining true to your principles, being a spiritual teacher to others, and consulting one for guidance, respecting your elders, all the past, and the power of prayer. So you're going to need guidance next week. So with the Prince of Spring, he's your shining, you know, a knight in shining armour. He's here to help you in whatever way he's needed. There's no two tasks that's too big and no detail too small. He won't rush in and take charge of it. If you need something done now, he's your guy. And as an endless after this, he's always smiling while he works. And once the job is done, you'll probably get a happy wink from him as well. Our prince is charming and courageous, confident and oh my so busy. That's because he wants to see everything, do everything, experience everything. Of course, there is a law in his action at that moment. You might find yourself with a very bored prince. A bored prince can be grumpy and impatient prince. It's hard for them to really relax and kick back when there's so much to accomplish out there in the world. On this card, the prince rides a rabbit, moving quickly from one adventure to another. Rabbits are known to be particularly active in the springtime, just like our prince. This is all about feeling alive, the urge to get busy, handling many things at once, issues that require speedy decisions and action and desire for adventure. So I already feel like you took action at the beginning of the week, but there's more action. You're going to be very, very busy. You're going to need some guidance in your life. At the end of the week, you've got Ace of Autumn, a windfall of money, advice or assistance from others, a very successful project and a happy change in your career. So something that's, your money could get better. So you have had advice from the guidance, and maybe you've listened to the guidance you're getting. And it's just going to, there's going to be a happy change. Now, we'll get you some oracle cards and see what the oracle says. You've got summer. As the sun's power increases, the season ripens, and almost imperceptibly, spring becomes summer, the time of nature's bounty and abundance. Summer's a season of relaxed and easy living, a gift to be enjoyed. It's ideal for riches involving creativity, fertility, expansion, and growth. I think you've got creativity in this. Jupiter. Named after Roman king of the gods, Jupiter is the largest planet in our solar system and rules business, growth, expansion, justice, and legal matters. Freedom and opportunity associated with Jupiter. Along with luck, good fortune, and fate taking her hand in your life and potentially redirecting the path you're on. Philosophy and the search for meaning all fall under Jupiter's reign. You got Neptune. The mysterious gas giant is the furthest known planet from the sun. It is named after the Roman god of the sea. Like the depths of the ocean, Neptune is linked to the depths of the mind. It is associated with the subconsciousness, dreams, illusions, and imagination, as well as transcendence and clairvoyance. Because of this, artistic pursuits are often linked to Neptune. So it's about emotion, sacrifice, and mysticism. So it's, it seems to be about sacrificing, letting go, reversal of fortune, and waiting for circumstances to improve, and for idealism, inspiration, and spiritual values. I'll now get some advice on the angels. Okay, you got Archangel Raphael. You're blessed to attract this angel card, for Archangel Raphael brings health, healing, and abundance. You got that as well. He'll help you to develop your intuition and inner vision. Call on him if you need him in these areas now. He also protects travellers during journeys, so this is a fortuitous card if you're about to travel. You're a healer or wish to be one. Archangel Raphael will direct pure divine energy to you. He works on the green ray of healing and balance, so visualise yourself surrounded by a clear green light and invoke his guidance. You also got communication. The angels remind you that being spiritual is about being genuine and honest. When you speak from the heart, others feel the resonance of truth and trust you. Talk positivity, focus on the good in your life, and you will feel happier and healthier. Communication is a two-way process. Listen with interest and respond openly. This will improve all relationships. Communicate constantly with source using prayer, which is asking, and meditation, which is listening. Always keep channels of communications open to be a bridge to others' hearts and minds. Ask your angel to step into your aura and communicate in a higher way through you. Spirit messages. Okay, pile two, you got don't indulge toxic people. And those who love her stay with us through a storm. So maybe you are getting rid of toxic people at the beginning of the week. Connect with your ancestors. As I heal my wounds, I heal my lineage and bring peace that reverberates in infinitely throughout time and space. For understanding our history, we'll gain a deep sense of appreciation for all the time and people it took to bring us into this world. Connecting with ancestors is one way to better understand ourselves and our patterns, and the patterns present within our lineage. It allows us to make peace with all that happened before. It also provides motivation to evolve and find new and better ways to live. Building this bridge is something you can do by researching and connecting the dots between family stories, DNA analysis, and traditional archives. You can also learn about your family line in more intuitive ways, like meditating, dream work, and working with a past life regression spiritualist, or someone who specializes in reading the Akashic Records, a metaphysical archive of everything that has ever happened within the universe, including all your past lifetimes and those that will come in the future. Call on your ancestors to tap into centuries and wisdom, protection and guidance. As you look back and connect with your forebears, your path forward will become more evident. Journal prompt what patterns or trends exist in your family line, especially among the women. These patterns appear in your life. Can you help them with their tarot card reading? Okay, so you got the North Node of the Moon, Capricorn, and number four. This is lessons that must be learned, fear of the unknown, fate, and the path forward. The zodiac die represents a situation, you know, how you're feeling in the situation and the emotions involved with the situation. This is controlling, possessiveness, business matters, barriers between people. The house die represents what parts of your life is being affected. Parents or parental figures, domestic issues, at the heart of your question, new land, real estate, inheritances, and the endings of a situation. Your letters. They are O, G, Z, G, A, F, R, K, E, P, S, X, V, and C. The numbers. Seven, two, six, eight, five, eight, and one. Let's go through this. Okay, you got a knight in shining armor. So maybe this is a relationship of yours, a friendship. You've got Jamie Fraser, so he's very lovable. Looks out for his family, his friends, anyone that's dear to him. He's very protective, very guarded. He's a fighter, he's very strong. You've got Slytherin here. So Slytherin is ambition, cunning, maybe loves snakes, love the colors green and silver. Shrewd, strong leaders, achievement-oriented, highly developed senses, hesitant to hesitate before acting and weighing out all possible outcomes. You also got number three. You got nothing can stop you now. And your sparkle has not gone unnoticed. You've got a little camper van here, so this is all about Christmas. The festive feeling, being with family, travelling. You've got the seahorse, so maybe you need to dive into something, be it education, new adventures. You have got the ring here, so are you married, engaged, or gonna get engaged? It's also about commitment. It also says path in life is going to be a positive one, uniqueness, wholeness, relationship. Influences on your family, they positive reflect. It's time to relax and enjoy with others, and people advice need to be listened to. You also got the key in your focus pole. So are you opening up to new things? Are you moving house? Are you buying something new? Are you need to unlock in answers? Are you needing to find out answers? Okay. Before I go, you also got the cloudy quartz. Well, they were your charms. I hope you enjoyed your week ahead reading. Hello, pile three. So I've got all your cards ready, and your beginning of the week is the High Priestess. Trusting your intuition, careful reflection before taking action, insights that come through meditation. So you need to be at next week, at the beginning of the week, trusting your intuition. You need to be careful before taking any action, and you need to do some meditation. At the middle of the week, you have Eight of Autumn. So do more research before proceeding. So that does fit with this card here. Education in the form of seminars, going back to school or apprenticeships, excellent craftsmanship or long-term projects. When I think of this card, I think about when I used to sit with my nan and she used to teach me how to knit. You also got Princess of Winter, inquisitive, truthful, realistic, undiplomatic, information that can help you but which may also be difficult to hear, speaking the truth with kindness, an indigo child or adult. So maybe you're going to be thinking carefully what to say to someone and you're going to be speaking the truth. Okay, and at the end of the week, you've got Three of Spring. Plan your next steps with an eye to long term. Have patience. There are good things to come. Satisfaction from a job well done. So you're going to be planning. And you're going to get to this point and you realise you've done a job. You've done a really, really good job. Your oracle cards is Spring. The arrival of spring represents a spirit of hope and fresh beginnings. So new beginnings are coming. is held in nature by bursts of fresh, vibrant colour, adoring gardens, parks and woods, some of nature's sweetest perfumes in the air. After long, dark days of winter, the first green shoots of life reappear, a sign that life goes on. It is a time of birth and growth, of natural energy and of hope and optimism for the future. You also got Uranus, named after the Greek god of the sky. Uranus is unique in our solar system in that it rotates on its side. It's somewhat appropriate then that its unusual planet is associated with. In Uranus' radicalism, irrationality, intuition and inventiveness, Uranus is the planet that rules chaos, so it's linked to rebellion, archery and the unexpected, but it's also linked to the freedom, unusual choices and risk. You also got the moon. Mysterious, magical and ever changing, the moon affects mood, sleep and dream patterns, mental health, germination and the growth of crops, tidal flows of the oceans, weather patterns in woman and fertility. The moon is ultimately linked with magic, weaving and understanding her phases is a central part of natural magic. Okay, your advice from the angels is synchronicity. There is no such thing as a chance in our incredible universe. The consequences and synchronicities are carefully organized by the guides and angels, so recognize them as the hand of spirit. Rejoice when you notice them, that they are the angels' messages to you that you are on the right path. Start to expect them and look for them. Be aware that there is a divine reason behind them and consider what the message or lesson is. Synchronicity is also a reminder to you that all things happen in a divine timing. So yes, that's about patience and waiting at the right time. You also got honesty. So you're going to be honest. Speaking the truth was one of the cards, wasn't it? This one here. Angel wisdom reminds you that your every thought, word, emotion, action is reflected in your aura. When you're honest, your aura is crystal clear. Everyone knows where they are with you and feels totally safe. The angels suggest that you look within and purify any mucky thoughts and feelings. When you're totally honest with yourself, you behave with integrity and dare to be open, for there is nothing to hide. People respect and trust you. As you radiate a response of honesty, people respond to you with openness and honesty in their turn. Messages from the spirits. You got those who love us, stay with us through a storm. Flow of life, not against it. Never go to bed angry. I live for little moments. And you're special. Remember to treat yourself as if you are. Your self-care card is pleasure. I am worthy of pleasure. Our bodies are magnificent temples of joy, bliss and ecstasy awaiting exploration. Most of us have an upbringing filled with limited perceptiveness about how we can experience pleasure and what kind is appropriate. As we begin to break free from constructive perceptiveness, we can re-explore our bodies and all our senses to find new and more profound experiences of pleasure. This exploration is a very personal progress, with the main requirement being an open mind. Begin by closing your eyes and tuning into your body. Ask yourself where you want to be touched and how you want to be touched. You can also ask your senses what they are craving. What does your nose want to smell? What does your skin want to feel? What do your eyes want to see? What does your mouth want to taste? What do your ears want to hear? Pleasure has unlimited forms and you can call in whatever one you desire. Journal for prompts. What kind of pleasure do you want to call into your life? Okay, let's do your dice and see what they say about the tarot cards. So you've got the moon, Virgo, and number 9. The planet die represents the situation at hand, and that's emotions, instincts, habits, moods, and the unconsciousness. The zodiac die represents how the situation is making you feel and the emotions involved with the situation. And this is rationality, solitude, pickiness, overly critical, and stirring for more than you can handle. The house die represents what part of your life is being affected. This is journeys, long distance travel, religion, philosophy, education, lawyers, dreams, divination, wisdom, the arts, media, and publishing. Okay, let's get some letters. You got A, V, A, O, F, S, F, and L. Let's get you some numbers. You've got 1, 7, 4, 5, 3, 6, 6, 7. So you've got 2 doubles there. Okay, let's get into this. So you have this guy here. He's Randall. He's not very nice, so very narcissistic, toxic, not a guy that you really want to have in your life. You've got wishes and dreams, so maybe you've been dreaming a lot, maybe you need to make some wishes, maybe you've made a wish and you want your dreams to come true. You've got a guardian angel here. You have the seahorse, so maybe you need to dive into some adventure or dive into your dreams. You have another guardian angel, and it's actually a March guardian angel. You have remembering someone you've lost, maybe. You have the cloudy quartz. You have about traveling, Christmas, being with family, the festive season, journeys. You have the amethyst in the shape of a heart, so that could represent protection of loved ones, especially with all the guardian angel energy I'm getting from this. You have this one, which is about water. It's about the throat chakra. It's about healing and reducing your blood pressure. And then you got acceptance, so you're going to be accepted, or you are very accepting of people, or you have people around you that are accepting. You have the umbrella, so maybe times have seemed hard for you, but don't worry. Things are going to start getting better, because I see it's trying to shelter you. You have a father figure or uncle figure. You have toothless, so a new friend is going to come into your life for a reason, a purpose. You know, it's all... or you've already got a friend like this. It's about soulmates, a Viking soulmate. It's just having this person that is a reason for being in your life. You have the red jasper stone. And, okay, you have the number 80 in here. And also you have the Slytherin badge, which their traits are. So, they are... ambition, cunning, they probably love snakes, love the colours green and silver, shrewd, strong leaders, achievement-oriented, highly developed senses, hesitate before acting and weighing out all possible outcomes. And I think you got that in your card reading today. So I hope you have a lovely week ahead of you, and I hope you enjoyed watching this. Goodbye.